how do I stay motivated in medical school? How do I keep going in med school? You know, I'm on my medical journey and I'm not sure if it's worth it anymore. If you said any of these things, guys, I think you're going to be really helped by this video because I'm going to break down how somebody going through a stressful time like med school or being a pre-med can make it work in their life regardless of who you are and what type of things you should do. I'm going to break it down to four that's going to help you stay motivated and be successful and finally get to that finish line. I think you're going to enjoy this video, so stay tuned after this intro. Alright guys, what is going on? Lux here from the MD Journey, helping you succeed on your medical journey with less stress. If you're new to this channel and you want to learn how to succeed on your medical journey, not by just surviving, but by thriving through tips and motivation, then go ahead and join the community by subscribing, like this video if you enjoy it, and help me reach my goal of 25,000 subscribers. But with that being said, let's get into this video's tip. I feel stuck. I want to become motivated, but I feel like I'm losing a part of myself on the medical journey. What type of things should I keep in mind to get me through the process? And so someone had asked me in the comment section what type of things I use personally on my medical journey to help me get through, whether it was family support system, it was all those things. So I'm going to give those tips and then I'll give you some examples of how I was able to use each of those things to get to the point where I am now, where I'm about to graduate medical school and enjoy the whole process and didn't feel that burnt out or feeling of regret. I hope I can help you get there too. So tip number one, I gave this in a previous video, but is try to have dinner, a meal, a Skype call with somebody outside of medicine and don't talk about med school. It's really hard for us when we're surrounded by our medical school peers, our faculty, our attendings, and most of our day goes from studying, clinic, come home, sleep, and repeat. It's really hard to not become a medical student 24/7. But you can break that cycle and stay motivated because you can feel like you still have a part of yourself if you include the people that aren't part of that medical school process. So for me, I'll give a personal example. You know, my fiance, I'll put a picture up here, has been with me through this whole journey of medical school and has been a huge support system. The cookies, helping me on my step one, just kind of support system, calls on a daily basis, Skype calls, whatever it may be. You need to have that kind of person in your life. It may not be a significant other, it may be a best friend, it may be, you know, anybody. It can be your sibling, it could be a parent, but that's one person who I, you know, deeply relied on during my journey. You just have to find who that person is for you. And so if you don't have a person to go to necessarily, it can be a variety of people, but try to have a meal with somebody outside of med school and don't talk about medicine. Once you do that, you feel like there's something scheduled on a weekly basis where you're no longer a med student, and that's perfect. And so you feel like you're losing a part of yourself and you feel like you're completely a med student at all times, I think this tip is gonna help you, and you probably need it more than you probably know. So find one individual, get a Skype call with them, or get dinner even better, and make sure, you know, set a vow to them and to yourself that you're not gonna be talking about med school. I promise you it's going to work wonders. So tip number two that you can do is make sure you find time for your personal hobby. Now, I didn't say hobbies because sometimes that's tricky in med school, but find one thing that you don't want to lose a sense of. For some people, it's something as simple as, like, I love fitness, and so I want to make sure my gym workout is, you know, a part of my daily life. For me, and for, you know, as you guys can see, I love creating content on helping medical students and pre-meds in their journey. So I'm always thinking about videos and blog posts that I can do for you guys. And so I need to make time to do that, because if I didn't have this platform, I think my med school experience would be completely different. So that was my personal hobby. You know, I would come in the computer and I'd write about something. I would write an email or create a video, and this is what the MD journey has now become, something that's a part of my medical school experience. So obviously you don't have to become a vlogger or a YouTuber, but you have to find that personal hobby. It may be something as simple as reading a book, you know, watching movies, cooking, but find time for it. You know, if you want more tips on kind of how to find time, go ahead and I'll go ahead and link a video in the description where I explained to a student of mine who had the same complaint of, I don't know how to find time for myself. Go ahead and watch that video. I think it'll help you out. But once you understand how to find that time, insert it with a hobby that you try to or plan to keep for your 4 years of med school. I promise you, you're going to enjoy it. Now, before I get to tip number 3 and 4, go ahead and just comment down below, what is one hobby you wish or you need to or you are keeping as part of your medical journey? It may be fitness, it may be reading, but I want to know, what kind of hobbies do you guys like and what are you making sure that you don't lose on your medical journey? So make sure you comment down below. Tip number 3, now it's going to sound weird, but I want you to create an impossible goal. Now hear me out. It may not sound like it's part of this video, but sometimes we become stagnant in the rest of our life because med school takes over. And so the same way I told you, you need to find time with somebody outside of medicine, you also have to set goals for yourself that are big that are also outside of medicine. So for me, you know, 25,000 subscribers, like I mentioned at the start, is one of it. It's outside of med school. I want to read 52 books this year. And so I have to find time outside of my medical school curriculum and, you know, obligations to do that. Those are my personal impossible goals. Just create one, something that as soon as you say it, your brain doesn't even ask you, you know, that's crazy. It just says, okay, you know, that's not gonna work. And so that's an impossible goal. Try to reach it and then reverse engineer on what you'd have to get there. It may be reading a certain amount of books. It may be getting to a certain fitness level. Maybe you wanna run a marathon at the end of the year and you haven't even ran a 5K. That's a good impossible goal. You can get there. It's just gonna require a lot of steps. As soon as you do this, guys, you put yourself in a frame of mind where, again, you're not a medical student 24/7 and you're able to focus on a goal outside of medical school that you can work in for a long period of time, because it is an impossible goal. You're not gonna be able to get there tomorrow. You can work on it day in and day out, and you'll have something on the side that you'll also enjoy pursuing, as well as becoming a physician. So create an impossible goal, just one. And if you want to see, you know, my whole list of impossible goals, I'll link in the description to my impossible list that you'll find on the blog post. And every time I accomplish one, I go ahead and mark it off. So that way you guys can follow my journey. You can see what goals I'm accomplishing, which ones I have left to do. But I encourage you to just create one impossible goal. I think you'll find it to be a great 2019. And see how far you get at the end of the year. So tip number 4 is a tip that I love giving throughout my videos as well as my blog posts, and that's the idea of the golden nugget. And I wrote a blog post recently of how to stay motivated in medical school even if you're in a slump. And there's something about motivation that sometimes we don't really understand, which is you think that the goal has to be good enough and you're motivated. But what we forget is that motivation is a cycle. There's a reason that med students like to study hard. It's because one day we decided, I'm gonna study hard, and you got the grade. And then that made you stay motivated to do it again, and then you got the grade. So now we continue to do it and we're, you know, natural hard workers. The same thing goes for when you feel like you're losing a sense of yourself in medical school. If you are studying a lot in your first or second year and you're like, I don't know if I can do this, ask yourself, was it worth the effort to get the result? That's a quote that I love giving out. Again, I'm gonna say it one more time. Ask if the effort was worth the result. So if you've studied in the past and you got the good results, you got the good grades, ask yourself, is it worth studying hard again to get that similar result? If you do really well with the patient and you love their interaction, is it worth to put that much effort in your future patient interactions? The answer is usually yes. So if you find yourself in a slump, ask yourself, what are those great experiences I've had? What led to that? And am I willing to put in similar effort to get that result again? Usually the answer, again, is yes. And so if you want kind of some help on figuring out what those golden nuggets are for you, there'll be a free worksheet that I'll go ahead and link down below that you guys can just fill out. And I break it down into a very like simple 3-step process. And if you understand what your golden nuggets are, guys, regardless of what medical school throws at you, I promise you're gonna be able to overcome it with a smile, some motivation, and you're going to thrive. Again, the whole idea is not surviving. We want to thrive on our medical journey. So those were my 4 tips on how to get out of your slump and stay motivated on your medical journey. So again, I'm gonna break it down. Number 1 is to find somebody outside of medicine and just do something with them, whether that be dinner, a Skype call, and don't talk about medical school. Number 2, make sure you have a personal hobby and create some time out of medical school to give some time where you can be involved in it. Number 3, create an impossible goal and reverse engineer it so you can work day in and day out and think about it until you get close enough, if not, to actually accomplishing it at the end of the year. And finally, find your golden nuggets, because those are gonna be huge when you are in a slump. And again, that worksheet will be in the description down below. But that's gonna be it for this video, guys. Before I end, again, I want you guys to comment down below, what is one thing you're gonna take away? You know, if you're not motivated right now, what principle of those 4 would you use that you think is gonna help you get out of that slump? I'd love to hear to see if this was helpful. And if you want more videos like this, just let me know and I'll be happy to make them. But as always, make sure you give this video video a like if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel. Help me get to my impossible goal of 25,000. And that's basically it. Share it with a friend, and I will see you guys in the next video. Take care, guys.